Assalamu alaikum, kaise hain aap log, theek thaak hain? Right now I'm in Amsterdam, and in Amsterdam I will be meeting lots of people, and it is zero in 2018. I will be covering a very amazing personality from crypto world. He has been reviewing lots and lots of people.
Suppoman!
Suppoman, how have you been, brother?
Good, yeah. I'm absolutely roasting right now. I picked the wrong clothes for the weather.
So can you please tell me, before I get into your crypto world, how exactly Suppoman routine is?
My day-to-day routine?
Yeah.
I get up, I look at CoinMarketCap, that's basically the first thing I look at, CoinMarketCap, and see what the price is, make sure that I'm right on my predictions. At the moment, I'm wanting Bitcoin to go down, it hasn't gone down. God, there's 126 people, this is awesome!
Yeah, so you will enjoy more.
I think it will go down, but that's what I do in the morning. I look at CoinMarketCap first,
yep.
Then I get out of bed, get my laptop out, and I start doing a little bit of ye olde research, looking at what's happening with the altcoins, what's happening in the crypto market, start putting together a video, and that's basically what I do. And my whole life is cryptocurrency.
And how many crypto projects or ICO actually bribe you to put a positive review?
Oh, well, okay. So I probably get about 20 emails, I get about 100 Facebook messages saying, show my ICO, and I don't respond to you. People probably think I'm rude, but there's just so many, and if I spent time answering all of them, then I wouldn't be able to do my own, get on with my own day, but I get so many.
So when exactly you got into crypto world? When was the first time you thought, oh fuck, Bitcoin, man, or Ethereum, or whatever?
My first actual trade was just over a year ago in Ripple. Ripple was my first trade. That was when I first went to cryptocurrency. And I got on it because of somebody else's recommendation. They said, Ripple's just been adopted by Japanese banks, you need to get into it. So I put $2,000 into it. And it went and it 20-something X on that trade. And then he said, get out of it.
Yep.
And I got out of it. And then it dropped. It sank. And I thought, I want to know how that guy knew. You know, I want to do this, because that was an insane amount of money in 2 weeks. $2,000 to $40,000. I was like, what? So I just learned.
Yeah.
So I just spent my life looking at every single video there was online, every single expert there was. I have a load of whale mates. That whale mate was one of them. And I said, how did you do this? So I just trained up, basically. Trained up and made it my day-to-day thing. And then I brought a Udemy course out on everything that I'd learned at that point. And now I just learn more. So obviously nowadays I just bring out a daily YouTube video so that I give more and more information of what I learn.
And you are like one of the most energetic and the most like happening crypto influencer, in my opinion. Do you call yourself crypto influencer? Is that a good terminology?
I don't know. Probably.
You influence.
Yeah.
I purchase U-Trust because of you. Because you start putting so much effort for U-Trust in January, I guess.
Yeah,
and you're like, U-Trust is a thing, U-Trust is a thing.
Yeah.
So my point is, how exactly you select a particular project? What exactly the top three things that you see is?
Vision is my number one.
Okay.
So other people say team is number one, no it's not. Vision is number one, because you have to have something unique that fits with blockchain, but is unique.
Okay.
Because if it's unique, it's got first mover advantage.
Yep.
And what I saw in U-Trust was, although they were payments, and there were a few other payment people out there, they had the buyer and seller protection, they had more options in terms of how many cryptos you could pay and turn into fiat.
Right.
But really, what I like the most is infrastructure projects. They're my favorites. So because these are like the operating systems where you build apps. So like they're like the Windows and the Mac OS's.
Is Suppoman married, engaged, committed?
No comment.
Too much of crypto. People want to know about.
No. I know. People want to know the real me.
Yeah.
People want to know the real me.
So you're single.
Hey Pete.
You're single.
Any women out there?
You're single, right?
Yes.
Oh, single, really?
Yes.
What's the zodiac? Like your Cancer, Gemini, what?
Capricorn.
Oh, Capricorn. That is why you're into finance. Capricorns are always into finance, too much into finance, and usually their relationships always get fucked up because of their finance too.
Is that so? Yeah.
So my question is, what exactly you see in crypto world in the future? Like lots of regulations coming in. Like I'm making a report on how to get this so-called license from Estonia, Malta, Switzerland. Are these licenses worth? Because once we get that license, we don't get a bank account in Estonia or in Malta. So what is the point of getting this virtual to fiat license?
Well, you know, I think personally it's just a way of regulators making money out of cryptocurrency. Mm. What I love about cryptocurrency is the fact that, you know, me, we can just buy crypto just like that. No regulation, there's no, I mean, obviously, you know,
anti-money laundering and such kind of stuff.
Yeah, there needs to be some level of control.
KYC is enough, I think.
Yeah, there needs to be some level of control, but not too much control. Because the moment there's too much control, you strangle the opportunity, you strangle the volatility.
Yeah.
And when I first got into crypto, I got into it for the gains. I was like, this is brilliant for the gains. But it wasn't until I properly read up into it that I thought, this is a finance and potential empire revolution.
This is
a asset that's not just an asset class you invest in. It's an asset class that can take over money and can take over government. So you peeps, if you're in there right now, that means you are part of this revolution in its early stages.
And Suppoman is from London, because you look like, when I saw you right now, I thought he's from maybe Dubai.
Well,
he's from Spain.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, my dad is Spanish, right? My mother's Mauritian, so that's in the Indian Ocean.
Yeah.
So I'm quite, what's the word? Multicultural.
So what's your parents or your family thinks about this crypto thing?
My mother's passed away, but she thought it was a bit risky when I talked to her about it. My dad at first didn't get it, and then now he keeps saying, tell me more about this, tell me more about this. So the other night, literally just before that big price spike, he said, oh, I'm thinking of getting into Bitcoin.
Yeah.
So I was talking to him about it, and now he's getting more and more interested. So I think that I am a lot like cryptocurrency. At first, you may be a bit put off, but then you warm to it and it grows on you, and then all of a sudden you become obsessed with it. And I think that's what happens with me. People watch me and they think, oh my god, he's so loud, he's so energetic, I don't want to listen to this.
No, I don't want to listen to you.
And then eventually they think, oh, he's alright, that Suppoman. So, you know, so there we are. There we are, Marble Arch.
So what exactly do you think about proof of stake or mastermind based coin? They have any kind of future? Because I always see a green in them. Entire market is going down, but since because of the staking thing, always they are green.
Yeah.
So do you think proof of stake has more potential, or proof of this mastermind kind of thing, a coin?
Depending. Okay, what I like about cryptocurrency is there's not one rule fits all. Yeah, so it's not proof of work's better, proof of stake's better.
Yeah.
What I like is that there is almost benefits to all. So the proof of work, the whole proof of work mining thing makes a network more robust.
Yeah.
So I love that. Proof of stake gives more benefits and dividends to holders.
Yes.
That's what I like. And masternodes is like a super version of proof of stake.
Yeah.
So you get ultra dividends.
Yes.
And I think in the banking world, there are certain companies you invest in that they give you an annual dividend every year, and it's the same. And the higher the dividend, the more that is like a master. So I think there's going to be space for all.
My question is that, do you think all these Ponzi schemes like BitConnect or OneCoin, BusCoin, this coin, that coin? Now, these things are really loved in countries like India, Pakistan, Dubai. People invest huge, like there's some shit, pay diamond, and people are investing like millions. Do you think using that multi-level marketing and combining this technology, can we come up with a plan which can actually entertain the people, and like we can incorporate multi-level marketing so that we can entertain these people also who are really into earning quick profits? Is there ever going to be a combination of these things?
It'll be difficult. If there's regulation, it'll probably be easier, because like there's another one called Proof of Weak Hands, right, which loads of people got into and hated. As soon as it looks obvious there's a referral scheme, people are like that.
Yes.
You know, if it's an obvious marketing scheme, people are like, oh, it's pyramid, it's Ponzi, I don't want to know. Yeah. So I think that if regulation comes in and adds that layer of trust, then yes, it could work in the future, but people are anti-BitConnect and anti those kinds of schemes.
Yeah.
And because if something sounds too good to be true, I mean, crypto already is too good to be true in a lot of respects.
Yeah.
So something like BitConnect was almost way too good to be true, and it worked for long, and it made so many people money that people want another scheme like that.
Yes.
So there's always going to be people that go for it, but those people are probably going to end up being hurt until some regulation comes in. So as long as it's not too restrictive regulation, it's probably good for the industry.
So when was the last time you actually dated a Pakistani Arabic woman? Have you ever dated anyone from Arabic?
I dated an Indian girl when I was at university. How was that?
Was it bad? Good?
She didn't put out easy. That's all I'll say.
So when exactly you think this market will actually going to go up and again going to be that flashy thing which was in December?
I think that there's, I said this, I think about a month ago, that there was going to be a gradual recovery in April. But I think that come May, and especially June, is going to soar like shit.
And your three top picks for newcomers right now who want to...
One chain. I would say one chain.
Yep.
I would say you trust. The last one's a tough one because there are so many good ones, and particularly blockchain. I think that the one of the best ones hasn't yet been released, and that's Hashgraph.
Yes, definitely. The technology is amazing.
Yeah.
The technology is amazing, and I think, but there are bandwidth issues in that. Like when they are validating each other, there will be a huge bandwidth coming in, and that bandwidth, I don't think so, that is something that people are ready for it.
Because
so much payment has to be made for that virtual server.
Yeah.
So, but then again, where are you partying tonight?
Where am I partying?
Yeah.
Partying?
Yeah, the partying thing.
With you trust lads. They're having an after party. Are you going to it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Mike, when you're going to come to Dubai or Pakistan? Have you been to
Dubai? Coming to Dubai on the 3rd of May.
High five! High five!
I'm coming to Dubai for the Futurama.
Yeah. Box mining will be there too, yeah.
Yeah, box mining will be there.
So who are like the number one crypto influencer beside you? Like you watch him and say, okay, he's doing also a good job.
Oh, that's a great question. Because I don't really follow anyone. No, it's true. I don't really follow anyone. The only videos I watch are my own.
Because they are so long, if you keep watching them,
you
will end up sleeping.
Yeah, I learn from myself. I like quite a few people. I like everybody's got their own niche in cryptocurrency. Yep. So I like watching people for different reasons. I like watching Cliff High. He hasn't got a YouTube channel, but Cliff High is really good with his predictions, because what I like about cryptocurrency is that it is a very emotional thing.
Yep.
You know, people think that it's a logical thing. So like with Ian Ballina, he does his data metrics, token metrics, and it's about the data.
Yes.
And it's about logic.
Yep.
It's not. That emotion. As soon as you invest in something, you become emotional about it, and the more they excite you, you become more and more emotional, and that is how the perceived value goes up and up and up. So therefore Cliff High I like, because he's got a very good barometer on the emotions of people. I like box mining for news. I like Crypto Daily for entertainment. He's just fun. I just watch him to have a laugh, you know what I mean? To like get a bit of a release from sometimes the seriousness of cryptocurrency.
Yep.
And those are the only two YouTubers. Oh no, I watch Ian Ballina as well.
Wow, that's amazing. It was lovely talking to you. And whenever you're coming to Pakistan and Dubai, you have to party with us.
Alright. Yeah, you sound like a good girl to party with. Okay. Yeah, hey.
Thank you so much.
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Adios, peeps. Adios. Don't forget to subscribe to Team Suppoman. Abs.